Welcome back to the channel. Thanks to my sponsor PCBWay. We reached 500 subscribers this week. Thank you very much. I'm really happy about that. Today we're making a presence detector for home assistant using an ESP32 and LD2450. In my preparations, you can see here I am soldering a Wemos D1 Mini, but later on I learned that a Wemos D1 Mini is not suited for this. The module we're using is the LD2450. This is my test setup. Ground and 3.3 volts are easy. The other pins depend on which board you're using. In my case, D16 and D17. I put the pin outs in the description below. You see me put in the USB cable here to test it, but that's not the port you use to program the board. Here you choose the file and you can download from the link in the description. After installation, you reconnect the board and configure the Wi-Fi. Then we go to Home Assistant, install ESPHome, and configure the devices he discovered. You can add a room to the device or keep it open. You can see here the device added a lot of sensors. We are going to use these sensors in the automations later on. First, we're going to add a custom card. In the background, you can see how we're going to install Plotly graph card in Home Assistant. Even though the footage is in Dutch, the steps are still the same. After the installation, we're gonna add it to our view. When inserting the card, go to code editor and paste the code I'll provide you. When you paste the code, close the code, go to the integrations, find the device and find the device name. Then go back to your view and choose to edit the card. When editing the card, press Ctrl F, find replace underscore me and replace this with mmWave underscore sensor underscore the number we just found. Then press replace all. Now let's see if it's working correctly. In my case, the locations of the targets are not properly shown. I'm gonna swap the values of the x-axis range, and this way the image is gonna be mirrored and the locations of the targets aren't shown correctly. After adding it to Home Assistant, I designed the PCB to get a smaller footprint and make it fit in a case. This was version 1. In version 2, I ditched the connector cable to attach the LD2450 and plug it directly into this board. I did leave the pin connectors there if you want to use the connector cable instead. Thanks to PCBWay for sponsoring this video. PCBWay is best known for manufacturing PCBs, but they also do CNC machining, 3D printing, and much more. Also handy is the PCB prototype assembly. Go check them out on PCBWay.com. For this project, I made use of the assembly service, and as you can see, it looks really good. Next, I designed the case for it, small and compact and easy to fit together. If you like the trays I designed for the Opta-Terra box, they are available on MakerWorld. I'm using 4 M3 5mm screws for this. Yes, I know the screwdriver is electric, but it doesn't have enough torque to get into the plastic. As you can see, the assembly is simple. It doesn't get much easier than this. To set up the zones, you need an app called HLK Radar Tool. It's available for Android and iPhone. I'll put a link to the app in the Google Play Store and the Apple Store in the description below. In the background, you can see how you can manipulate your zones and add one or multiple in there. It's important that when you're finished doing the zones, click submit and save your changes. When we're finished, it's time to create our first automation in Home Assistant. We're gonna add an automation that is triggered when presence is detected. In this example, we'll use the action notify instead of turning on a light or turning on something else, just to see how the trigger is reacting. Let's adjust the zones and create different actions for every zone. Let's add an automation that triggers when presence is detected in a certain zone and does the action notify. We also add the trigger that no more presence is detected in the zone. Action is the same as before, notify, send a message. You can change this in whatever you want, turn on a light, turn off a light. Now we save it for zone 1 and then we duplicate it for zone 2 and zone 3. You only have to adjust the values and after that save it as zone 2 and the third one as zone 3. After all this is done, let's test the new automation and see if it works. I think it's really responsive and you can use any action you want. If you want more of these videos, please let me know in the comments below. And again, thanks to my Patreons. Like and subscribe, or you can support me on Patreon. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next.